Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Carmine Sabia for Explain America, and Fox News host Laura Ingraham, she got the Democrats dead to rights. Before we get started, please make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Those little things really help us out, and they help our channel continue to grow. Now, Jason Chaffetz was hosting Laura Ingraham's Ingraham Angle this week when he had on as a guest Laura Ingraham. And he found it very interesting to have her on. Obviously, it's her show, and now she's a guest, and he's hosting, right? They talked about Trump being removed from the ballot in Colorado, being removed from the ballot in Maine, and Laura Ingraham, I think, nailed it really well with her assessment of what happened. You see, these are Gestapo tactics. These are Banana Republic tactics. If you're not afraid that this man can defeat you, if you think he's going to be an easy opponent, as you have claimed, well, then why? Why must you go through lengths that go past the voters to stop him? Well, Ingraham, she had an idea about it, and I'm going to let her tell you about it. But before we watch that, I want to ask you again to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Again, it really helps us out. I'm Carmine Sabia for Explain America. We love you guys. God bless you. Take care, everybody. Now, let's watch Laura Ingraham.
Breaking news. It's stunning to me that we are at this point in our country, but what's your reaction to this?
Well, look, let's cut through the haze here. This is going to ultimately, unless something bizarre happens, be overturned in the Supreme Court. We all know what the Michigan Supreme Court did. They rejected this 14th Amendment nonsense. I mean, I don't want to repeat what the previous guest said, but obviously Donald Trump was never charged with insurrection. He was never adjudged by a court to have engaged in insurrection, certainly not in any legal sense. So what this really is voter suppression, which ironically, the voters of Maine have said overwhelmingly they're against. You know, the ACLU on their website, as I was listening on hold, Jason, the ACLU on their website has a whole page devoted to protect the right to vote. Maine votes no to voter suppression. Now, this is back in 2011, November 9th in 2011. And I'm thinking to myself, this is hilarious. Like, what is more suppressive than removing a candidate from the ballot who is leading, I believe, in every state in his primary? In the Republican primary, I mean, what there is no higher definition of what a suppressive behavior is or conduct is. So they are engaging in the very conduct. You know, this is judicial interference in the election process in the representative democracy, and this is suppressing the right to vote on the part of, you know, obviously Maine residents who wish to vote for Donald Trump. But in a dozen challenges across the country, funded by these far left interests, with the sheen of being bipartisan, you know, have the veneer of, oh, this is a bipartisan challenge. You know, they find some never Trump former, you know, state senator, and then a Republican turned independent former state rep, and then they have a Democrat or a liberal mayor. So they put together this group of plaintiffs, and they say, oh, this is bipartisan. That's just a joke. It's obviously not bipartisan. They refuse, yeah, or they simply do not wish to allow the voters to have their say. This challenge is ridiculous. This ruling is ridiculous. Sheena Bellows is a far-left activist. Trump is right about that. She's totally biased. She's no different from any of the other, you know, DAs or local prosecutors who, you know, just see that the idea of Republican voters being able to vote for the candidate of their choice, whoever that candidate is.
Yeah, I think it's not only suppression, but I also think it's intimidation. I think it's there to also help try to drain the money out of the Republican coffers and end up in all of these legal fights. And it's fundamentally wrong. I do hope and I do believe that the independents, the true independents that are out there, are highly offended by this because they were the ones projecting that, oh, this is what Donald Trump would do if he were in office. And yet they're the very ones doing it right now. We have 4 years of history with Donald Trump. He never tried any of these shenanigans.
Bingo. So who is the autocrat now? Where is the autocratic behavior coming from? I would submit it's coming from the left. which refuses to allow people to make basic decisions about their lives, whether it's how they move around, what type of vehicle, what type of, you know, cooking surface they use, you know, what type of heating they're allowed to use in their homes, corporate censorship mixed with government censorship as we're approaching this this hot election season. So I think what's going on is that as we get closer to actual voting, you're going to see this. I believe this is the tip of the iceberg. There's going to be much, much more in the way of lawfare, other hyperbolic statements about Donald Trump, which are border on the hilarious. I mean, if it weren't so serious, you know, this could be its own, you know, reality show of inanity, because the comments of like Trump's never going to have another election. I mean, who are the people who don't want to have an election with the candidate of the people's choosing? I mean, but Donald Trump's never going to have another election once he gets in. I don't even think they believe that, but they're just basically throwing anything against the wall. Meanwhile, our country's, you know, obviously being completely overrun by illegal aliens as we speak.